Hi, back again with Red Stabler. In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect to MySQL database and make a simple query in Electron application. Now my example application, I have a blank page with an empty div tag. The next thing I'm going to do is to create a script, a JavaScript to connect to MySQL database and put the result in this div tag to show on the application. But before we begin the coding, we need to install MySQL module with npm first. This module will let you connect to MySQL database on Node.js application. So I'm going to close the application for now and install MySQL module with npm. Okay, we are good to go. Now let's take a look at the example code on MySQL module official page. To make a connection to the database, first we need to load the module, of course, and next config the connection setting, like host name, the credential, username and password, and the database name. After that, we make the connection, and then we make the query, and end the connection. And that's all we are going to do. To save the time, I will copy the code and place it on my example application. Now let's take a look at my database. I went ahead and set up some dummy data. Now I will update the setting to match the database. The localhost is correct. I didn't set up any user, so the default user should be root and the password would be null. The database Electron DB. Next, I'm going to select the only table we have, the employee table. So I'm going to update the query. I'm going to select employee ID and employee name from employee table. And pass the SQL into the query. Now after we made the query, there are a couple things returned to the callback function. The first one is error. If there is any error about the query, you'll get that in this one. So inside the callback function, if there is any error, I will throw it out. The second one is result. This is the result of your query. It will be in an array format. And the final is fields. This will hold all the information of the fields that you select in the query. Now I'm going to log the entire result array to the console so we can see the structure of the array. Now let's start the application. Open the developer console. You see we got 4 rows returned, which is correct. Now once we got the result array, displaying the information on the application screen is pretty easy now. You can just use the jQuery to select the result div. and display it. So for example, if you want to have the first row result, let's restart the application again. Hello, John Doe. So that's the basic. I hope this video helps you to get through the first step to connect the database in your Electron application. So let me know if you have any questions, any feedback to my tutorial. Don't forget to check out other interesting videos from our channel and subscribe. Bye.